So now we will need a pure alcohol, okay, to wash the aperture blades in it. They are very oily, okay? All spare parts I put in the pure alcohol, and then we should clean out also here. Okay, so I use this from one side and from another side. But mostly from this side because oil is concentrated here. Now it's time to clean blade per blade, okay? Once it's done, I take it and put to dry. And finally the ring. So, as you can see now, the blades are very dry without oil, and our task now to put it at its place inside. It's not so hard as it might be thought. Especially when it's like in Helios, only 8 blades, it could be harder with Jupiter 9, for example, lens. There are 15 blades, or for example, with a Tahir lens, telephoto lens. So now we start to put the aperture blades on their place. It's most important, let's say, somehow most difficult operation of all what we have performed, okay? So you see this part round. It should be put like that, here, okay? One. Two. Three. Till 5 blades there is no problem at all. Now it's somehow tricky because the holes, they are under blades, under first blades. So we need to push the blade on that side to let it be on its place, okay? So it's quite difficult work. And now we have to put finger here in order not to let the blades in place to get from their holes, okay? And this we need to push. Up till its place. So it is on its place, and now we need to here, you know, lift it a little bit. To let be on its place. Look here, you see? It's whole up. Here we have. So the 6 here on its place. Now it's the same thing, a little bit tricky thing to put another one. You take it with your finger here, you know, because this one on its place, and another one from another side we need to put here. So in order not to let these blades get from their place, you put the finger here. Here. So first of all we need to put the blade a bit up. Now we put the finger and we push it. Is it right? No, it's not right because it's not its place. We still need to push it a little bit. One little bit more. Hop, here we have, look here. As you may see, it's on its place. We need to put the last one. We take it. We put under first blade, under, up, like that. We put the finger and we push. We put the blade in order to let in the hole. click. Yes. Now we can see all the blades. All the blades are at their place, okay? All the holes. So, the most complex part of the work is done. Now we need to place this ring. This ring has a hole for the screwdriver here. It's very important to put the hole in the way that this hole will be on the top extreme right side here. Our hole need to be here. So we take it. Here is a hole, and we put inside. We check it. You see, we need to adjust just a little bit. Hop, it's in place, and you see the hole is here for the screwdriver. Now it's simple. We need to put this ring inside. It's very simple, you just put it. First you need to do this. Here we have. So let's see if it works. Our blades. You see, it's working without problems. And it's completely dry without oil. Now everything what we need to do is to assemble the lens. So there might be some dust on the glass. We clean up the glass here. And we screw it. We check up the holes here, you see? Hop. And we put inside these two micro screwdrivers. And second one. So it's done, okay? Now we clean one more time the optical pieces. And then we put it on its place. Then we put this part. We made the markings on it here and here. Here is our mark. We need to see another side. Here we have it. See? Oh. So here is our hole for the screw. Oh, it was like that. So we take our screw and we put inside. And we put this another one. As you can see, the preset mechanism is working as well. It's very important to make the marking on the lens in order to adjust after when you assemble, in order to adjust the right side. Then you put the ring, then you put the helicoid part. Hop. Now what you can see, we have completely dry aperture blades. Okay, I think it's it's worse to do this. If you feel capable, repeat all these manipulations. You will have aperture blades completely without oil. So it was a Retrophoto Ukraine.